Welcome back friends, it is our second video on rule-based classifier. So here we will talk about how to build a rule-based classifier. Now to build a rule-based classifier, we need to extract a set of rules that identifies key relationship between the attributes of a dataset and the class level. Okay, so there must be a training data, and from the training data, we apply some technique apply some methods to extract the rules now the methods, there are two types of method. First one is what? Direct method, and second one is what? Indirect method. Now in direct method, extract classification rules directly from the data. That means what? We have a training data and directly we apply the methods, direct method to get the rules. Okay. Now in indirect method, from the training data, first apply other classification technique, for example decision tree or neural network, and from the neural network or decision tree we can apply some methods to get the rules. Okay, so that is the basic difference between direct and indirect method. Next, we'll talk about direct methods for rule extraction. Now, if then rules can be identified directly from the training data using a sequential covering algorithm. So here we'll talk about algorithm. It is called sequential covering algorithm. Here the rules are learned sequentially, one at a time. Okay, so here we apply a sequential covering problem to identify the rules from the training data. So what is the sequential algorithm? So first of all, we should know the basic steps of the sequential algorithm. Okay, so it is about our algorithm, sequential covering algorithm. So in input, we have to input the database D and attribute values. So it is ATTVal and their possible values. Output will be a set of if-then rules. Okay, so the return will be our I's, so set of rules. So first step is what? An empty rule set is created. Second step, for each class C, let database, three classes are there, say red, green and blue. So C1, C2 and C3. So for each class CI, repeat rule set learn one rule. So call this particular function learn one rule, where the inputs are D, okay, input D, attribute value, okay, attribute value, and the C, the class level, and it will return one single rule and it accommodates into the rule set. Now remove data covered by the rule from the D. Now once the number of rules, the number of data which are covered by this particular rule, we have to remove those data from the database, and we have to iterate this the process continuously until convergence criteria is satisfied and for each of the class. And this algorithm will return the rule set, of rules. Okay, now we'll discuss the steps one by one. So first step is what? Create an empty rule set. So algorithm start with an empty decision list, it is called rule set. So first of all is what? We have to use one decision list using empty decision list. Now step 2, for each class C, okay, we have to repeat to identify the rules until convergence criteria is satisfied. So the learn one rule function is then used to extract the best rule for the class CI. that covers the current trading data. Okay, so a rule, so here we have to call the function learn1rule. Okay, learn1rule functions, where three attributes are there: the database attribute value and the class level. A rule is desirable if it covers most of the class CI and none or very few of the data from other classes. Now, once such a rule is found, the training data covered by the rules are removed. Now, we can see one simple example to explain this one. Say, okay, now we can explain this particular algorithm. This is what our training data. Now, here, two classes are there. Say, circle class and the plus class. Now, first of all, we have to identify the rule. So, here, that covers the current training data. Okay, and we have to, that rule is, the desirable rule is what? It covers most of the class C. So we can see most of the class plus is somewhere here. Okay, so if you can identify rules here from this one. So we can identify rule from this particular section. So we assume it is rule 1. Now once rule 1 is extracted from this one trading data, we have to remove this particular rule. So you can see here there is no data in this section. Okay, now you can see this particular algorithm. So first we have to for each class C, so first of all you have to solve the class plus first. So after that, most of the data are here. Okay, so 3 plus are there and 1 0 is there. That means very few other classes is there. So assume it is rule number 2 from this one. Now we can see after extracting the rule 2, identify rule 2 from this particular training data, we remove this data also. Okay, now we have this particular training data, and now we go for the class circle, class 0. Now here we have to identify the rules. This is nothing but our rule, and finally we have to remove this particular data. Now we have these 3 data which are not covered by any rules. So diagrammatically we can explain this particular algorithm. Next we'll talk about convergence criteria. So every time we are using this particular term, until convergence criteria is satisfied. So when there are no more training tuples or the quality of your tuples removed is below a user specified threshold. Now here we can see here, we can accommodate this data also. Okay, or what you can do, we can stop here and we identify the default rule for these 3 uncovered data. Okay, so in this way we can cover all the data. So here we can identify rule 1, rule 2, rule 3 and these 3 uncovered data for the default rule. Now the next question is, how are rules learned? Now there are 2 ways, general to specific and specific to general. Okay, so first of all we discuss about general to specific. Now start with an empty rule. Okay, start with an empty rule and then gradually keep appending attribute test to it. Now here we have to suppose we just append some attributes. Say here, okay, here B, here. Consider each possible attribute test that may be added to the rules. Okay, and each time a new attribute is added to the current rule, picks the one that most improve the rule quality. Now this process repeats, where at each step we continue till acceptable quality level. So we can explain one simple example. So we can use our old example. This is what our old example. Now 14 data are there and 4 attributes, input attributes, features are there, and one class level is there. So high school marks, college marks, post interested, communication skill and campus job. High school marks low, medium, high. College marks low, medium, high. Sports interested, yes and no. Communication skill good and excellent. And here these are the training data. Already these data are there, where campus job no or campus job no, whether he or she will he received the campus job or not. Now we can see, we can start with a one empty list, say this one. So if it is blank, then campus job is equal to yes. Starting with one simple empty list, there is no precondition or antecedents. So there is no precondition or antecedents, but one conclusion is there or consequence is there. The consequence is what? Campus job, yes. Next, we search, just append some precondition or let's, so if high school marks is equal to low, if high school marks is equal to medium, if sports interested, yes, and if communication skill is equal to good. Now out of four, we have to evaluate the rules. We have to evaluate the rules and pick up the good one. Let's, this is the best one. Now how you can pick up, we'll see later. So let's, this is the best one. Then further we append the attribute. Let if sports interested, yes, and communication skill is good. If sports interested, yes, and communication skill is excellent. If sports interested, yes, and high school marks is equal to medium. Now note that in every case the conclusion or the consequence are yes. In every case conclusion will be yes or consequence will be yes. Okay, then yes. Okay, in this case also then yes. Okay, now once again we have to evaluate the rules. So three rules are there. Now this is one rule, another rule, and we have to identify the best rule. Let's, this is our best rule. Now then we have to identify, we have to append the attributes. So in this way you have to continue the process. Next is what? Specific to general. So one of the example is randomly chosen as the initial seed for the rule growing process. During the refinement phase, the rule is generalized by removing one of its conjuncts so that it can cover more positive examples. That means what? Here, that means where? Here we accommodate all the attributes. A simple example, say x1, say x2, say x3, and x4. Then say consequent, say ci. So you have to remove one by one. Let's say two branches are there. Say in this section we remove x1, so you just retain x3 and x4, then ci. Here we remove the c2, that means if x1, x3, x4, then c1. Here we remove x3, that means x1, x2, x4, then c1. Here if x1, x2, x3, then c1. Now evaluate the rules, which one is the best rule. Let's, this is what our best rule. Then we have to eliminate any one of the attribute. Say from here we can eliminate x1. So if you eliminate x1, that means what? If x3, x4, then c1. Here we can eliminate the x3, that means if x1, x4, then c1. Here if x1, x3, from here we eliminate x4, then c1. Here we'll discuss the indirect methods for rule extraction. Now using, already you know, using neural network, using decision tree, we can extract the rules. Now in using decision tree, every path from the root node to the leaf node, now this is what our decision tree. So every path from the root node to its the leaf node of a decision tree can be expressed as a classification rule. Now the test conditions encountered along the path from the conjuncts of the rule antecedents while the class label at the leaf node is assigned to the rule consequent. So that means here we can identify the rules. So we can identify the rule 1. So if high school marks is equal to low and sports interested no, then consequence is what? It is campus job no. Similarly, we can identify the another rule. If high school marks low and sports interested yes, okay, consequence will be what? Campus job yes. Similarly, so these are the rules we can identify from the decision tree. Now after that we can refine the rules. We can generate the rules. Now to generate the rule, we remove some conjunctions. Suppose we have removed some this particular attribute and check whether it simplifies the rule or it increases the quality of the rule or not. Now after that, after generating the rule set, rules that predict the same class are grouped together into the same subset to implement the rule ordering. So here yes, we keep all the rules together, yes, yes, and yes, and no, no together to implement the rule ordering. Now characteristics of rule based classification. So first one, the expression of a rule set is almost equivalent to that of a decision tree because a decision tree can be represented by a set of mutually exclusive and exhaustive rules. So the power of this particular rule or expressiveness of this rule almost equivalent to the decision tree. And rule based classifiers are generally used to produce descriptive modules that are easier to interpret. So it is easily to, you can understand the rules and we can identify the consequence okay with the help of preconditions. So with the help of rule based classification and from the rules we can identify the rules, we can interpret the rules properly. Okay, and that is the end of this particular video. Thank you very much.